Hey everybody, welcome to the Canter Fire Truck Series. So what we're doing today is we're installing the Max Air fan system on the roof.
Thought I had mine. Just a marker and a straight edge and I'll draw it and then he's still looking.
Hey?
No. Goofball.
Don't tell him.
I'm not. That's the funnest part about it. Here he comes. What are you smiling about?
I feel better.
A little too much information. Hey, you want to grab this as it falls in? Just don't look up until I get done cutting.
Max Air fan is just a central located fan in the truck. And what that's going to do is create ventilation for us. It's going to pull heat out. It's going to blow cold air in. We can set it up a couple different ways. It also has a rain sensing portion to it where if we're running it and it starts raining, it will automatically shut itself, but it will not shut the fan off.
That's a lot better. It's oozing now. It's coming out the other side though, so you're going to have to grab me some a putty knife and a little thing of acetone. I got the acetone up here.
The reason we have these is you do not want to button these trucks up 100%. The biggest thing that you hear time and time again in regular RVs is people are starting to develop mold issues or condensation issues. You are going to make condensation just by breathing alone. You're going to let out that moisture during the wintertime. You're going to see that in your windows. So by having a little bit of ventilation and running that fan even in the wintertime, it's going to pull some of that condensation out. It's going to create movement of air inside. You're not going to get that mold issue.
Yeah, I'm not gonna paint it black, I'm just gonna leave it. It's gonna get all marked up, huh?
Octagon check?
No, I think that's gonna be too hard to do. I think we just do a big rectangle behind it or something.
We build up all of our accessories in shop. We do buy some things from other vendors. Our propane tank mount, we don't make that in-house. But we will build the custom spare tire carrier in-house because that's kind of a one-off, one-fit thing for this particular design and setup that we're doing on this truck. With the designs that we're coming out with, we actually keep these in our CAD file and we're gonna probably continue to use these because they're working for us. So that's what we got going.
That's perfect. You can put a piece of the 4-inch wall stuff on that and gusset it. That's not gonna go anywhere.
So if you have any questions about any of the products we've used, leave a comment in the comment section below the video and we'll get back to you with the product details.